Good morning, students. Welcome to online teaching session of Academic World School Bebetera. So today we are going to discuss Geography Chapter 1, that is India's size and location for class 9 students. So in this chapter we will discuss about the location of India, size of India, India and the relation of India with other countries in the world. Then, who are the neighbors of India? We will discuss one by one. Before that, I want to tell you something about your previous classes, about some previous information. So, as we all know that there is a question arises in our mind that what is geography? Actually, geography is a study which studies about the earth and the solar system. And second question arises in our mind, who is known as the father of geography? So, as the Greek astrologer, Eratosthenes is considered as the father of geography. So now, that's why to know about the solar system and the location of sun, star, then your asteroids, meteoroids and different planets, we study geography. And that's why in this chapter we will discuss about our country India. Now we will discuss about some introduction about India. If we go to the mythological period, that is during the Upanishad, Ramayana and Mahabharata. So in that mythology we can see that there was a country in the name of Bharat. So where it was located, that Bharat? And later this Bharat came to be known as India. Now this country India is divided into 28 states and 9 union territories. So in this chapter we will discuss about what is the actual size of India according to the longitudinal and latitudinal extent, and what is the length of India from north to south and from west to east. So we will discuss all in this chapter one by one. Now we will discuss about the location. So I am going to show you one example picture, so you can see it, that the location of India. And if we go to the earth, if we go to the earth, then the globe, we can see, can you see this globe? Can you see this globe? That this is known as the North Pole and this is known as the South Pole, and this shaded area is known as the North Temperate Zone. This middle portion area is known as the Torrid Zone, and this southern part is known as the South Temperate Zone. So in this location we can see the imaginary horizontal lines, they are called as latitude, and the imaginary vertical lines on the globe, they are called as the longitude. Now our country India is located in the northern hemisphere, that is northeastern part of the hemisphere. So we will discuss about the northeastern part of the hemisphere and where India is located. So as we all know that the earth's rotation is going on from west direction to the east direction. So due to this rotation from east to west to east, so it happened the changes in the day and night system on the earth. Now we will discuss about this. Now you can see our country. This is the north side, this is the south side, and the distance of the north and south, that is 3240 km. Similarly, the distance from west to the east, that is of 2933 km. Can you see it? Remembering, it might be important for you. Similarly, so we will discuss all these distances and information according to the longitudinal and latitudinal extent of India. That is of 30 degree both from longitudinal latitudes and longitudes. Now, the size of India. If we go through the size, India is located in the southeastern part of Asia. India is located in the southeastern part of Asia. So the peninsular part of India stretches towards the Indian Ocean. Remember it? Now, So whenever this total landmass, that is called as the mainland of India, that is called as the mainland of India. This mainland, the boundary, it covers around 15,200 kilometers. This is total, yes, 15,200 kilometers, the total boundary. Similarly, including this union territories, Andaman and Nicobar Island, then your Lakshadweep Island, the entire territory or mainland of India is covered 7,516.6 kilometers total. So this is the actual size of the mainland of India geographically. Now, we will discuss about different problems what India faces now. Because of its geographical location, now India is developing through technologically, economically, socially and politically. So now in this chapter, we will discuss the rest of the things. So you have to go through your books, informations are there and they are mostly important. Properly see this map, if you want to know, you can know. Now, we will discuss about the India and the world. That how India having the relationship with other countries in the world. So now again you see this map, this southern part of India, that is Indian Ocean is located. Indian Ocean. So through this Indian Ocean, we can see that this Indian Ocean is located in the central part of both Europe and eastern part of Asia. So through this Indian Ocean, the people of India, they are doing trade and business and commerce with the European countries, African countries and the Eastern Asian countries since the earlier days. So that's why the importance of Indian Ocean is much more having value, and India keeps its trade relations with other countries in the world. So that's why the traders from Europe, the traders from Africa, the traders from South America, the traders from North America, they all visited to India through this Indian Ocean. That's why the importance of Indian Ocean, as its name, have been much more importance like the country India. Similarly, the country India having the relationship only of trade and business with other countries in the world because of the location of Indian Ocean as a central part in the southeastern part of Asia. So this is why this is the subtopic, that India and the world, that means how India maintains its trade relationship with other countries in the world. So in this chapter, we discussed all these things. Now, I am showing you one more important thing, that you must have known that so many countries, they are located near and around our country. Suppose, I am going to show you again this map, properly see it. You can know so many informations. Now, this is our country India. Can you see it? Now, imagine that nearby India, many countries are located. Can you see Pakistan is there? Can you see Afghanistan is there? Can you see in the north part, that is Tajikistan is there, touches to the border of Jammu and Kashmir? Can you see China is also located here? Even if Nepal is also located here, then you can see Bhutan is located here, Bangladesh is also there, then Myanmar is also there, if you go to the southern side, Sri Lanka is also there, then the island country Maldives is also there. They are the nearby countries of our country and they are known as the neighbors, because most of the time these countries are dependent on our country and our country also sometimes depend on other countries. So that's why these are the neighboring countries of India. So these countries basically Sri Lanka, then Pakistan, Nepal, China, then Bangladesh, Myanmar, Bhutan, they are the very poor and developing countries, and most of the time they are depending on India for their economically, politically, socially, technologically development and needs. So these are our developing, these are neighboring countries, and if you go through the map of India, political map of India, you can know where it is located. The north part or northwestern part, can you see Pakistan is located, Afghanistan is located, then northern part, that is of Tajikistan is located, north side also China, Nepal and China, Nepal is located. But if you go through this northeastern side, that is Bhutan is located, then eastern part Bangladesh is located and Myanmar is also located. Southern side you can see that Sri Lanka is also located. So you have to find out that what are the capital cities of these neighboring countries and what are the islands of India. I have already told you that the island that is of Andaman Nicobar group of island, Lakshadweep group of island, then the inner territories like the Daman and Diu, then Dadra and Nagar Haveli. Now recently we have created two union territories also, that is divided by Jammu and Kashmir. Now we have one Jammu and one is the Ladakh. That is the new union territories. You have to remember because there was 29 states and 7 union territories. Now it is 28 states and 9 union territories. You have to remember it. Okay? Now we will discuss about some more information about the location and size of India. Now, can you see? This is a picture of a globe. Picture of a globe. This is a picture of a globe. Properly, can you see it? Memorize it. This is the North Pole and this is the South Pole. Now, this imaginary horizontal lines, this imaginary horizontal lines, can you see in blue color? That is known as the lines of latitude. They are known as the lines of latitude. Now, similarly, can you see the red color lines? They are vertical lines from north to south. These imaginary lines are called as the lines of longitude. Okay. So, and this thick line, can you see a bold line is there in the middle of this globe and it is showing in blue color, that is known as the equator. That is known as equator. Now, there are total 180 latitudes on the globe and total 360 longitudes on the globe. Now, we have to discuss one more information that our earth is rotating from west to east. Can you see this arrow mark of red color? Our earth is rotating from west to east direction on its axis. So whenever it rotates, generally it has moved toward the eastern region. That means the countries or the areas located on the eastern region. So they are getting fast time. After that, the rest countries, those who are located in the western side, they are getting some late. For example, there is a question that why sun rises earlier in Arunachal Pradesh and then rises 2 hours later in Gujarat. Because of there is a lag of 2 hours gap. Because this happens due to the reason that the rotation of India, that is one degree of longitude takes 4 minutes. 1 degree of longitude takes 4 minutes. So when it rotates 15 degree, so it takes generally 60 minutes. 15 into 4. Then whenever it rotates 30 degree, because I told you that latitudinal and longitudinal action is 30 degree. Similarly, this 30 degree whenever it rotates, then it takes 15 into 4 or 30 into 4. Sorry, 30 into 4, 15 into 6. So what happens? This 30 into 4, it takes 120 minutes. So this 120 minutes is equivalent to 2 hours. So that's why whenever the sun rises in Arunachal Pradesh earlier, the same sun rises in Gujarat 2 hours later. For example, if the 5 a.m. in the morning sun rises in Arunachal Pradesh and in Gujarat the sun rises at 7 a.m. So that's why there is a lag of 2 hours in our India rising of the sun. Okay. So that's what is called as the lag of 2 hours region because of the differences and the rotation of the earth on its axis in on the earth. Now, can you see this line that is called a Tropic of Cancer? This Tropic of Cancer, it is passing through the middle part of India and it divides India into two equal halves. This is called as the Tropic of Cancer. It is located on the 23.5 degree in the northern hemisphere, remember. So that's why this, due to the location discussion of this topic of cancer, it divides India into two equal halves. And there is a standard meridian which passes through Mirzapur in Uttar Pradesh near to Allahabad. If you see your map, you can see that there is a standard meridian which line passes through Mirzapur of Uttar Pradesh near to Allahabad, and the Indian standard time has been fixed because from north to south or south towards north, if you go, there is a length of many times, that is more longer time than the west to east, because the west to east size is just smaller. From north to south of India, it is longer. You can see from this map also the length of this north to south. You can see there is a total length of 3214 km. Similarly, from west to east, this distance of 2933 km. What happens? So generally, whenever, because this location of southern part Kanyakumari is located, you know, and this Kanyakumari is located just near to the adjacent area of equator. So that's why a person, if go to Kanyakumari, he will get just early time, for example 5 a.m. here, then he will get the same time 7 a.m. here in the Jammu and Kashmir, because of the distance of the area and the places from south to north or north to south. So you see this map again. From this is Gujarat, this is Arunachal Pradesh, this is 2 hours gap. Because of this, I told you the rotation of the earth according to its longitude and latitudinal extent. Got it? Any doubt? If you have any doubt, you can ask also, and you can write your question through ERP, you can ask also. Now, I have to write some questions for you, so you have to prepare, you have to go through the books and you have to write it answer. Now, I am writing the questions on the board, you note it down. Open your book exercise. Now I am going to ask you some questions. Question number 1. Can you see that the topic of cancer does not pass through which of the following states? I am just writing the answer, you have to note it. Question number 1, that's of NCQs. I am just giving the answer, you have to see your question also. So MCQ shows the first question, that which of the following topic of cancer does not pass through which of the following state? I am giving the option. Option A, Rajasthan. Option B, Chhattisgarh. Option C, Odisha. Option D, Tripura. Can you tell me any one of these? The topic of cancer does not pass through which of the following state? That is option A, Rajasthan, option B, Chhattisgarh, option C, Odisha, option D, Tripura. That is correct answer is option C, that is of Odisha. So this topic of cancer does not pass through Odisha. That is of answer is Odisha. Similarly, next question, I am just telling you, the easternmost longitude of India is dash. The easternmost longitude of India is dash. Now, option A, 97.25 degree in the east. Option B, 68.7 degree in the east. Option C, 77.7 degree in the east. And option D, 82.22 degree in the east. Which one is correct? Now, in these four options B and option D, both are correct. So you have to note it. Option B and option D, both are correct. So answer is option B and option D. Similarly, next question. Now, Uttarakhand, that's in Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal, and Sikkim have common frontiers with which country? Try to understand the question again. Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal, and Sikkim have common frontier. Frontier means border. So have common borders with which neighboring country of India? Should I give any option? Okay. Now, option A, China. Option B, Nepal. Option C, Bhutan. Option D, Myanmar. Which is? That's Nepal. Very good. Correct answer, Nepal. Now, the next question, properly listen this question. Now, if you intend to visit Kavarti, Kavarti, you know, Kavarti is the capital of Lakshadweep, the island. Kavarti is the capital of Lakshadweep. Now, question is, if you intend, desire to visit Kavarti during the summer vacation, which one of the following union territories of India you are going to? I told you the answer, now you find the answer. Option A, Puducherry. Option B, Andaman and Nicobar Island. Option C, Lakshadweep. And option D, Daman and Diu. Lakshadweep, very good. Correct answer is Lakshadweep. Now, next question. This is a very interesting question, properly listen. My friend hails from a country which does not share land boundary with India. Identify the country. Now, properly listen the question. My friend hails from a country. That means my friend has come from a country, but his country does not have any boundary with India. Identify the country name. Now, I am giving you the option. You can easily find out. Option A, Bhutan. Option B, Bangladesh. Option C, Tajikistan. Option D, Nepal. Which is? If we say properly, Tajikistan here it is given because rest of the countries having the borders with India. Tajikistan also having the borders with India. But here in this book it is not given. Actually, that is of Tajikistan. According to the exercise answer of the book, it will be Tajikistan. So, tick mark the Tajikistan also. Now, so answer is Tajikistan. Correct? Now, you have to note it down also this. Now, we are going to discuss some other questions. Properly listen and note it down also. I am just giving the question, try to find out the answer from the book. These are the question number 6 of exercise 1. Now, name the group of islands lying in the Arabian Sea. Which group of islands that is lying in the Arabian Sea? Can you guess? I had already shown you just few moments before. Which are the islands that is located in the Arabian Sea? That is Lakshadweep. Yes. Lakshadweep group of islands that is located in the Arabian Sea. Okay? Now, next question. Name the countries which are larger than India. I told you one information that India is the 7th largest country in the world. So before that, 6 largest countries are there. So one is Russia, the biggest, then North America, then South America, the continent. Then North America, then you can go to China, then France, Germany, these are the some biggest countries are there. So you have to find out which are the 6 biggest countries, then India. So these are your assignment. I will also send you the assignment through ERP. You have to download your assignment through ERP and you have to write the answer and you have to send me back also. Now, again, we are going to recapitulate this chapter. So, properly listen, I told you that we discussed in this topic that is India size and location. I told you that this India size and location, that geography is a study of, that is of solar system and the earth science. Similarly, I told you also that the Eratosthenes, the astrologer who is known as the father of geography, and I told you that from the mythological period, the location of India was very important, and most of the time India has been known as different names from the ancient period, that is Bharat, now it is known as India, sometimes it is Hindustan. And the location, I told you that the location of India is the northeastern hemisphere on the globe. So, and it is located in the northeastern part of northern hemisphere, remember. And the Tropic of Cancer, that is passes through India, which divides this India into two equal halves, and the entire boundary, the total boundary, coastal boundary of India, that is 15,200 kilometers, and the total landmass, that is mainland including the island, islands and union territories of India, that is 7,516.6 kilometer, and the distance of India from north to south, that is 3,214 kilometer, and the distance from India from west to east, that is 2,933 kilometer. You have to memorize this one. Because of the rotation of the India and the rotation of the earth on its axis from west to east, and there is a difference of latitudinal and longitudinal differences which shows different time in different places. Similarly, I told you one example that the sun rises in the Arunachal Pradesh 2 hours before, whereas the sun rises in Gujarat that is 2 hours later. And due to the longitudinal and latitudinal extent and differences of this thing happens. If you go through the book, you can read it also. I told you that because of location of this Indian Ocean as in the central part, in the southern eastern part of Asia, that the trade relation and commerce relation with other countries of Europe, Africa and Latin America and other eastern countries, and that's why India having the important relation because of the location of Indian Ocean in the southeastern part of Asia. Similarly, I told you that India's neighboring countries, that is of western part, the northwestern part, if you see, that is of Pakistan, Afghanistan, then Tajikistan, then north part China, Nepal. If you go to the eastern part, northeastern part, that is Bhutan, eastern part, that is Bangladesh and Myanmar. If you go to the southern part, that is Sri Lanka, is located as our neighboring countries. So in these countries, most of the time, the dependent, so that is economically, technologically and socially, most of the countries of India, that's why they are in good relations with us. And in this chapter, we discussed all these things. Now, if you have any doubt, you can write in the ERP, you can send this message, and we will start again the next chapter. Thank you. Have a beautiful day.